The following graph shows the number of miles from home a child is on Saturday. Use the graph to tell the rate of change in miles per hour for each interval as requested. Explain the meaning of each rate of change in a sentence. So, to review, rate of change is when you find the amount of change in your output variable to the amount of change in your input variable. So we know that the input variable is always on the horizontal axis, and the output variable is always on your vertical axis. So in other words, we're going to find the change in the distance over the change in the time. So if I look at this graph here, I see a horizontal line. So from 8 o'clock to 10 o'clock right here. So that's what we're requested to find out first, to find the rate of change from 8 to 10 a.m. You could just look at it and you just know that a horizontal line has a rate of change of 0. Or mathematically, if we do the rise over the run, if I pick two points, so I pick this point and let's say this point, I would not have to rise to get to this point over here. So my rise is 0, and then the run, we'd have to run over 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, 0 divided by 4 is 0. So our rate of change is 0. So what that means is that for those 2 hours, the child is not getting closer and is not getting further from home. Okay, so here we have given the rate of change like it asked, so it's 0. And then we've answered the direction of the child. The child is not going towards home, is not going away, it's just staying wherever they are. Maybe they're at a friend's house, maybe they're at the store for 2 hours, but their distance, they're not getting any closer or any further, so the rate of change here is 0. Okay, so if we look at our next interval here, so this time from 10 to 11 o'clock, in that hour there, you can see that the line is going downward. So since the line is going down, we know that the slope or the rate of change is negative. So from the left to the right, so from here to here, remember if you think of a roller coaster and you can only go from left to right on the roller coaster, it's going down. So that's how we know that the rate of change is negative, or the slope is negative. Okay, so now to find slope, we pick two points. Any two points where we could read the point. So we wouldn't want to pick this point right there because it doesn't go through the corner of a square. So I'm going to pick these two points right here, and I'm going to rise 1, 2, 3 boxes. And then I'm going to run 1. And 3 divided by 1 is 3. So we would get negative 3 for our rate of change for our slope. Now we could also pick, let's say, this point and this point. So then I would have a rise of 6, and I'd have a run of 2, and it's going down, so that's how we know it's negative, and we would get negative 3. So we get the same thing. So you could pick any two points and do rise over run. And that works because every two boxes is equivalent to a whole, to 1 hour, 1 mile. So that's why we can just count the boxes like that. So from 10 to 11, the rate of change is negative 3. So now we need to explain what this negative represents. So the negative is representing, because it's going down, it's representing that if this is the distance from home, and we know that the origin here is at 0, that the distance from home is getting smaller and smaller. That means the child is getting closer to home. So we would say that the child's distance from home is decreasing. So that's explaining what the negative represents. Okay, by 3 miles per hour. Because again, 3 is the same thing as 3 over 1. And we know that the rate of change is the miles and then the time, the hour. Because we talked about that rate of change is a change in the output to the change in the input. So that is how we know it's 3 miles per hour. Okay, so if we take a look at the next interval from 11 to 1 p.m., okay, so we see that the line here, or the graph here, is a horizontal. So we know that all horizontal lines have a slope of 0, a rate of change of 0, or again, if you pick 2 points, like if I pick those two, my rise would be 0, and my run would be 2, and 0 divided by 2 is 0. So the rate of change from 11 to 1 is 0. Okay, so if you notice, right here, the distance from home is 0. So right here, for those 2 hours, the child remains at home. So the child is not moving, increasing, or decreasing distance from home because the child is home. So the child is at home for these 2 hours. The distance from home does not change. The child is just sitting around for 2 hours at home. Okay, so if we continue, now we're going to take a look at our next time, so from 1 all the way to 3 o'clock. So we're going to go ahead and pick 2 points. So I'm going to go with this one and this one here. So I'm going to rise 1, 2, 3, and run 1. And then to find out if my slope or my rate of change is negative or positive, we look at the graph, like we're riding a roller coaster from the left to the right, we would be going up. So the slope is positive. And then 3 divided by 1 is just 3. So the rate of change is 3. So if we look here, since the slope is positive, we have to explain why it's positive and what that means. So that means that it's going from 0 because he's at home and he's going away from his home. So the distance from home increases. And now I have to explain what the 3 is. So the distance from home increases by 3 miles per hour. Okay, so now we take a look at the next time period from 3 to 4:30. So first thing, from the left to the right, it's going down. So we know that the rise over the run, the rate of change, the slope is negative. So then we're going to go ahead and pick 2 points. I'm going to go with this one and this one here, and then I'm going to rise 2, and then run 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. So we got our rate of change is negative 1. Okay, so we have to explain what the negative represents. So the negative represents the child's distance from home is, as you could see, it's up here at 6, and now it went down. So the negative represents that the child's distance from home is decreasing. Now we have to explain what the 1 represents. So it's decreasing by 1 mile per hour. And remember that we could also instead say 1 mile per hour and abbreviate it that way. Okay, lastly, we're asked to find the rate of change from 4:30 to 6. So we're going to go ahead and pick 2 points. So I'll pick this one and I'll pick this one. And then I'm going to rise 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm going to run over 2. So 4 divided by 2 is 2. And since the line from the left to the right is going up, the slope is positive 2. Okay, so we need to explain what the, since this is positive, what the positive represents. So from 4:30 to 6 o'clock, the distance and time are both increasing. So the child's distance from home increases. Now we have to explain what the 2 represents. So increases by 2 miles per hour. So I'm going to abbreviate that. Miles per hour.